Now we'll study Pauli's neutrino hypothesis. This hypothesis was given by Pauli just to explain how the three conservation laws, which were apparently not valid in case of beta decay, can be considered holding true. Let's first write down about it. Pauli suggested that during beta decay, an additional particle is also emitted called neutrino. Which is responsible of missing data in making conservation laws valid in this process of beta decay we are talking about. And according to Pauli, neutrino has the following characteristics. After studying the characteristic of neutrino, we'll see how by using neutrino emission and beta decay, the three conservation laws will hold true. The very first characteristic about neutrino is its charge is zero, like a photon. Number two is it is an energy particle like a photon. Number three is if we are talking about it as an energy particle, its rest mass is zero, again like a photon. But the unlike characteristic it has from photon is it carries a spin angular momentum like a nucleon, which is plus minus half h over 2 pi because it is produced from within the nucleus. And similar characteristic with photon we can write. It carries linear momentum like a photon. And another point which was important about neutrino is it has two different kind of spin angular momentum and opposite directions which are considered as neutrino and antineutrino. So it was considered that in a beta plus decay, a neutrino which is written as nu, the symbol used for neutrino is nu, is emitted, and in a beta minus decay, an antineutrino, which the symbol used is nu bar, is emitted. Only difference between a neutrino and antineutrino is in their spins. So we can write for beta plus emission as well as for K capture here we can use. The reaction used is 1P1 which gives a neutron plus plus 1E0, this is the beta plus emission and this beta plus particle, and it is accomplished by emission of another particle neutrino. And similarly for beta minus emission, the reaction is now written as 0 and 1 when a neutron transforms into a proton, and a beta minus particle minus 1 E0, which is beta minus, is emitted. This emission is accomplished by emission of an antineutrino. This is the way how the reactions are written. In this situation, we can see the difference of energy between this beta plus and beta minus, and the daughter nucleus with the parent nucleus is taken away by the neutrino, and using the linear momentum of neutrino, conservation of linear momentum will also hold true. And as it carries the spin angular momentum, which is opposite to that of beta particles, overall spin angular momentum will also remain conserved. This is the way how by this Pauli's hypothesis we can explain that all conservation laws hold true in case of beta emission.